Go ahead, you start.
When I first met Dan, I had lost the ability to walk earlier in the year in May. So it was new to me. And I thought, oh my God, I was single at the time. I'm never going to find a man who wants to be with a woman in a wheelchair. And then, cue Dan Dickman.
Jennifer showed up. I had this event, and I was like, I think she's really cute. I need to bring my A game today because I want to impress this girl.
And he did impress me.
In a married relationship between two people with MS, it seems like MS would be a major component. It's a big part, but I think it's because I don't see where it limits us.
It's not like a woe is me. It's a challenge, and he always says, challenge accepted, I'm going to overcome this.
People always say, oh, I'm not going to let MS define me. I'd rather say we're defining what MS is and what MS can be.
If you don't feel great about yourself, and sometimes I don't feel great about myself, but if you don't feel like you're someone to spend time with, then why would you expect someone to want to spend time with you? If I were to look back, I would say, have faith, you are more than just a wheelchair. I'm a person who has hopes and dreams and a sense of humor and really good taste in music and sports teams, and I enjoy my life.
For anybody living with MS, is you need to surround yourself with just incredible people. And I had to make the effort to get out to go to this event. And I didn't go down there looking to find love. I just went because it sounded like a good program. Well, there she was. Life is changing, and it's probably not going to be the way it used to be or the way you had envisioned, but
But
I.
it could be so much better. And finding each other, that's more than either of us could ever have imagined.
Yeah.